Hey guys, Jake from Make Science Fun here. Thanks for joining me today. Now, in a previous episode, I did this vlog where I built this saltwater engine car kit. High quality, fun to build, worked so-so, you know, did sort of travel. But today I'm doing not a prank call. I'm gonna ring these guys up and have a bit of a discussion, hopefully, with them about this claim that says it's an entertaining educational kit demonstrating the concept of a salt-powered automotive engine. Well, it is definitely not salt-powered. It's powered by this little piece of magnesium, which corrodes, and you need salt to make it happen, but the energy doesn't come from the salt. The energy actually comes from this magnesium. So I think that is a false scientific claim. I'm going to give them a bell and see what they've got to say. So here goes. Let's give them a buzz. I'll phone 73. Oh, shouldn't tell you the number. 555. Call.
Your expected waiting time is between 30 and 60 seconds.
Phew, got that again. Yeah, g'day, how are you? My name's Jacob and I've recently purchased a saltwater fuel cell engine car.
Oh yeah?
And it's a really good little car, like it built together quite well and it runs okay. Except the problem is on the front of the box it says that it's a saltwater powered car. And as it turns out, it's come with like these little magnesium pieces of metal which obviously power it. And so once those magnesium strips are gone, even though you've got lots of salt, the car sort of stops working.
Ah, okay. Is this that little kit one, is it?
Yeah, that's right.
Yep.
So I guess my concern is, as a science teacher, that the claim that it says on the front of the box that it's salt water powered is actually an incorrect claim.
So you've tried to use salt water to run it?
Yeah.
Already?
Yeah, so it runs,
yeah.
But it's not powered by the salt water. The salt water activates the magnesium ribbon, but then once the magnesium has corroded and the ribbon's gone, doesn't matter how much salt you put in it, it still won't go.
So you're looking to maybe get a refund on the unit or something like that, or?
No, not really. I guess I'm looking at a bigger picture that it's I guess it's a little bit of a false claim that it's salt powered. Do you know what I mean? That it's salt water powered when it's actually not. I try and teach kids, you know, to question things. And so for me as a science teacher, I don't really like seeing this like free energy business or this salt water powered business, because it sort of like gives misconceptions, so to speak.
I see. Yep.
Hmm. Uh-huh.
Yep. All right, the description of the unit itself, does it, because online it says something a little bit different, but maybe on the box it claims it just runs directly off just salt water.
Yeah, so it's a bit mixed, so I'll give it that, because it says the concept of a salt-powered automotive engine, so it sort of sounds like the power's coming from the salt when it's clearly not. However, it says that when salt water is added, it dissolves the magnesium to form hydrogen, which is attracted to the cathode, creating a flow of electrons. So it's not fully misleading. Like, it's got it's got some good facts there. I guess what might be a helpful addition is that it says that once your two magnesium strips are finished, then you'll need to get some new magnesium strips or something like that, because you sort of get the feeling that it's going to run forever on the salt water, but it's not, because otherwise we'd be able to run it from the ocean. We'd never run out of energy.
Put emphasis on magnesium for its use within it, instead of just having it more on the salt water side of it.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. So, look, maybe it's just something you can flag, could be looked into.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Sure. Okay. Well, yeah. If it's going to be worded that way, yeah, I can understand. So, I'll write up an email and send it to our marketing team, see if they can change the wording, perhaps, or whatever they can do to make it less, say, reliant on the saltwater side of it. On the selling point kind of thing.
Yeah.
Sure. That's not a problem. We can definitely send an email to our marketing team for that. It's not a problem.
That'd be terrific. And, you know, if you could do that, I reckon that would go a long way to make science fun. What do you think?
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah. Do you like to make science fun?
Myself? I'm not so much into science myself.
Oh, what?
I just work on the phones pretty much.
You're joking me.
Like I say, if you'd like, I can always put your details on the email if you'd like.
Sure. That'd be terrific.
So just a name and anything like that?
Yeah, I'll give you my email address.
Sure, what's your email address?
It's at Jacob.
Jacob, yep.
At?
Yep.
MakeScienceFun.com.au.
All right, so easy, Jacob. Well, thanks for your time and your input, and I'll get that to our marketing team.
Okay, thanks very much.
All right, thanks for your time again. Have a good day.
Bye. Oh, well, it's going to their marketing team. And who knows, they might adjust the label to indicate that it's not just salt powered, but the salt helps. It's actually magnesium metal powered, and when the magnesium runs out, then you need to get some new strips. Oh, well, that was quite fun. So thanks for joining me today. Hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't, and I'm looking forward to seeing you guys next time. Bye for now.